now in studio. Erika, welcome to BYU Sports Nation.
Thank you.
You know, you make the rest of us look really, really bad. That's your accomplishments in the last 123 days.
No.
I'm like, what have I done the last 123 days?
I've done nothing compared to this.
Not that. And congratulations specifically on taking a fifth in the steeplechase last week. Congratulations. All-American again.
Yeah, thank you.
What were nationals like for you in Austin? We heard it was pretty muggy, but a pretty good time for the team.
Oh, yeah, the team did so good. Clayton Young was so inspiring, winning the 10K, and it was just an awesome week for the team. It was hot. It was super hot.
It was very hot. How did that affect you in the race and your prep?
I didn't feel it in the race because you just get in that race mentality, but it was hot.
How do you handle winning? Is it more... that it's done, you can kind of relax? Is it elation? Like, what's that feeling like right after you win an event?
It's just an exciting moment when you win, I'd say. I don't know. I didn't win. What do you mean?
But I mean, just like when you're done and you have this accomplishment behind you, like what's that moment like when you know you're going through these, you're setting records, things like that we've been talking about. What's that like?
I think it's just like, probably a moment of shock, just because like you didn't realize that you could do something and then you do it, this big accomplishment. So it's just like really surprising.
When did you realize, okay, maybe I can set records? Or did you ever?
Yeah, probably just the start with the DMR when I didn't even know we were going for a record, and then we got this record, and so that was just the start of it. It was exciting.
And you get to put your name up. It's like a formal process, right? You guys gather around, you clap, someone gets on the ladder, right? So you've done this five times. Is there one that sticks out among the five?
Trying to think. Probably just getting the mile. A couple of years ago, that's the only one I trained for, is the indoor mile, and I just never thought I could run under 4:35. So that was really exciting.
So it's you grew up in Hoytsville, Utah. Mm-hmm. So now we actually had to look up where Hoytsville was. It's past Park City, so it's up that direction. What was it like to grow up in Hoytsville, Utah? What is there to do in Hoytsville?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of like people. I don't know what people do.
What did you do growing up?
Well, I mean, I run a ton, so I ran.
You can run in Hoytsville?
Yeah, it's beautiful. It's a country. It's like just open space. We went swimming a lot. There's Echo Lake, and I don't know. It's just like a small town country.
Just a no pressure, relax, yeah. Great place to grow up, I assume.
Yes.
Are you the greatest athlete from Hoytsville, Utah ever?
No.
Was there someone else?
I feel like there was a football player.
There was a football player. Okay, so you're number two on the best athletes
from Hoytsville. Sadie Sargent is also from Hoytsville.
Okay.
She's on the track team.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Does she have five school records?
I was going to say, does this
football
player?
She's a freshman, though.
Okay, so she could have five school records.
Or six. But as of today, you're the best, is what we're saying then. Can we at least go there?
I feel like a football player went pro, but I don't know.
All right, we're going to do this research. We're going to have people do some research.
He didn't hold five school records.
No, he did not.
Yeah,
he did not.
You've had an interesting and very, interesting path getting to this point. So you went on a mission to Cleveland, right? Mm-hmm. What was that like? Where'd you go? Columbus?
Cleveland.
So Cleveland as well.
Probably a lot earlier than she did.
You basically tried to reactivate some people that Jason taught, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. How was Cleveland on your mission?
I loved it. We served around Kirtland.
That's cool.
Yeah, so it was an awesome experience. I'm really glad I went.
And then you get married and you have a kid, Jack, year and a half old, and you still are able to break these records. Just going to school would be hard enough, let alone being a runner. So how did you balance this journey of, okay, I've got to get my body back in shape, and by the way, I'm going to have a kid and get my body back in shape, right? What's this road been like for you?
I mean, it's just been a process. Coach Taylor just made me an easy step-by-step plan of how to come back after having a child. And I think that for runners, having a baby, it honestly makes you better.
How does it make you better? Because most people wouldn't say, yeah, this is going to make me better. It'd be a challenge, right? Uh-huh. But you say it makes you better. Why so?
It just gives you a different kind of perspective and confidence. And I'm probably older and stronger.
Speaking of,
let's bring in Jack.
The little one. We're gonna bring. Yeah, he's gonna make his television debut today.
We've never done this. We're almost 6 years old. I don't think we've ever brought someone else's kid up here.
Hi,
Jack,
buddy.
You doing okay? I heard you crying out in the hallway. You okay, buddy?
Hi, Jack.
He can.
Can you do high fives? Do you know how to do high fives?
Yeah, you do.
You do high fives?
You gave him a high five.
High five?
Well,
good job.
See, now he's smiling. Now he's good. Those little baby tears coming out. I know those all too well.
All is well. He's back with mama now.
See, now Jack's watching this on YouTube years later and going, why was I so obsessed with the microphone?
Why didn't I say something?
Can you wave?
Can you wave, buddy? He's got a little basketball.
Hey, mama.
I wish I had a little baton, Erica. We can figure that out, but yeah. Well, congratulations on a tremendous career. It's been a path that's been certainly unique, and you've overcome some things that I don't think everybody could. So congratulations on being the second greatest athlete from Hoytsville, Utah.
Thank you.
We're also going to have, since you have your son, we won't ask you to right now, but we'll have you sign our Sailor Krug flag as well.
And let's give you the karma
yes.
for your senior year. We look forward to at least one more school record.
Okay.
So that'll be awesome. Erika Birk-Jarvis of Track and Field. Awesome.